We've been reviewing games for quite a number of years, and some reviews you might have even heard on the radio show. Now, an audio review is alright, but you gotta have the visual aspect. You need to see the graphics and animation in action. Well, I'm gonna solve this problem for you by reviewing one of my favorite games, Elevator Action Returns. It's an arcade game released in 1994 by Taito. This is the first true sequel to the 1983 arcade game Elevator Action. There you were controlling one character, Otto. In Elevator Action Returns, you can control one of three characters in a two-player co-op mission. You can choose from Cart Bradfield, Edie Barrett, or Jad the Taff. Each character has different attributes, speed, stamina, firing power, so forth. So pick your character wisely and get started. Your mission, as with previous installments, is to find red doors. This time, behind these doors aren't secret documents. Behind each red door, you have to treat bombs. There could be anywhere from 2 to 5 or so in each level. The game itself has 6 levels. Your missions take you from airport terminals to oil rigs and underground installations, as well as other locations. The first stage should take you back to the original arcade game. Afterwards, you'll start to do some basic platforming. It's not just riding elevators here and there. You'll have to walk. All three of your characters walk rather casual. If you double tap the direction you're headed, you will run. Your main weapon consists of a pistol. Each character has their own secondary weapon, whether it's a firebomb, hand grenade, or sensor bomb. The secondary is used by pressing the jump and fire button together. Certainly comes in handy in a tight gym and you need some air to breathe. If you throw your secondary while crouching, it will travel a shorter distance. Otherwise, while standing, this thing will fly. Now, there are blue doors in each level too. You can pick up mostly random goods, either items, health, or points. Scattered throughout the levels are weapon upgrades, like machine guns and rocket launchers. Take special care though, these weapons that you'll find have limited ammo. Your regular weapon has unlimited ammo, but it's always the better toys that come with just a pocket full of ammo. Go figure. There's a bit more of a plot to this installment. Basically, it involves a terrorist group wanting to dominate the world. Luckily, we don't have to sit through any cutscenes to help tell the story, and we can just play the game. Once in a while, the main enemy will stick his head in every now and then flood the area with a bunch of guys who fly in on jetpacks or whatever. Enemies will come at you from all around. They'll come out of doors or just be waiting for you. It's not just guys in black anymore. There are so many enemies in this game, from zombie soldiers to spider robots, hazmat squads, guys in trench coats, guys who know karate, and even guard dogs. Now, if you got a soft spot for poochies, you may want to pass on this game, because you do shoot at these dogs and they do yelp. The graphics for Elevator Action Returns are about as real as you're going to get for 1994. While the original game gave us a more friendlier style in terms of sprites and backgrounds, the sequel abandons all that in favor of a down and dirty atmosphere, complete with walls that have graffiti on it, the occasional enemy on fire, and a bigger variety of characters. The one gripe I had is that when too much is happening at once, it's hard to keep track of where you're going, and this time around you can fall down the elevator shaft. Jump over it? Yes. Jump down one floor? Apparently these new agents were not trained for that. The soundtrack for this game gives you themes appropriate for each scene that you're in. It's got a nice feel, it's not distracting, I approve. Once in a while your character will speak. I hear more speech samples from Cart Bradfield than I hear from any other character, and not because I picked him the most. I didn't hear much from the girl Edie. Jad the Taff's voice didn't quite match his otherwise friendly looking demeanor. But I didn't let that get to me, because despite his stamina in the game, he moves at a snail's pace. Besides, I didn't play this game to hear speech samples every 6 seconds. The sound effects are plentiful and will not disappoint. Adjusting to each character's attributes takes time. Edie's abilities are average, but she isn't the most powerful of the group. As I said, find which character is easy enough to adjust to and you'll be fine. Each one can fire straight and diagonally. Jumping over shafts is simple enough. Let's just say the control varies depending on the player and who you're playing as. Challenge? Oh boy. Is this game ever unforgiving? I can imagine how many quarters were lost trying to complete this game. There's only 6 frickin' levels. Remember, there's more enemies coming at you than in the original. The levels are well drawn out, so you'll do a fair share of platforming and, of course, shooting. The extra weapons do come in handy as long as you don't get trigger happy on just one bad guy. My final decision on Elevator Action Returns is keep it. It's plenty of fun, grab yourself a good arcade emulator like MAME, and a second player for this one.